Ta-da-da! What's up? And so anyway, I got a bit of news. So this is the Stedman. I got the freaking thing on here again. This is the Stedman Pro. Turns out, the story is. This baby, one more time. This is the Stedman Pro. For the fourth time that I've done this, this is the Stedman Pro. This on the top here is called an open book mark. Open book. I just found out about this. So, it's an open book headstock pattern, right? So far, that as far as I know, that's Gibson's, and not to be given to anybody else. But anyway, so it's really close. Looked up on the forums. I don't have my phone in front of me. I looked up on the forums, the guitar forums, for the Stedman Pro, because I wanted to know what the story was about them, because, you know, every guitar's got a story. Well, apparently, this particular brand has been out for at least over 8 years. That much I do know, because the forums go back to 2008. So, and people are talking about the guitars that they've had for years. All right, so we're talking maybe at least 10 years. If you find a Stedman Pro, chances are you're going to find them under a different name, under a different brand, because that's what they are known for. Not to the mass, not to the populace at large, but at least to one gentleman who was on there who said that he actually has a friend who's a supplier who back then was getting them for about $1.29, $129, anywhere from there to $250, depending on what model he wanted. He said he's got two of them. I can see that. They have a white one out there that's like, it looks like it's all right. But don't pay more than $129 to $250, because that's what they're known to go for. They're good quality. They're bolt-on necks. They don't have the greatest freaking tuners on there. God only knows whose tuners are on there. But they work fine. They hold. As far as I know, they hold the note. And the nut. I mean, there's, there are things on there that you can tell are like completely whacked. I mean, the nut is halfway on the body and halfway off the body, and but it's holding. It's holding. The pickups, it's probably meant to be replaced. Okay, I just happened to have replaced the nickel plated ones with these Zebras, and these Zebras are knockoff Zebras too, but they sound good in here, and I couldn't complain at all about them. This is on classic rock. That's clean. The pots. If you can replace the pots, replace the pots. Otherwise, if it's beyond your technicalities, don't bother, because there's just the swell in between, all the way down and all the way up. That's really, there's no change, or the change is so minute. You really don't notice it, and that also goes for the tone pots as well. Beyond that, they're functional. They work. They won't give you all the tones that you could possibly come up with, but they work. They're functional, and they'll take you to a gig. Basically, what I'm thinking. So that's what happens. It's basically. somebody comes on, they order a bunch of these, they slap their own logos on there, and then they sell them for their as their own for a premium. And that's what the deal is with these things. So if you outside of that, you know, it's a decent quality thing. I mean, if you look at the finish on that, You know what I mean? It's really not bad. I mean, it looks like what it is, you know? It looks like a flaming top, you know? The book matches book match. Like, that's why I was saying earlier, it looks like it was photo finished. Otherwise, it's a very decent quality veneer. And they did a decent job on the top. So anyway, like, you really need to know that. So that's the story with these things. So back in 2008. Now, I've seen them going on eBay and Amazon. And sure as shit, you know, they're going from anywhere from $89 to $5.99. I mean, I've seen somebody actually selling Joe Bonamassa's signed one, a black one. And so he's trying to get rid of it for like $5.99. Whatever. You know what I mean? I'm not paying $400 for a freaking signature. You're out of your fucking mind, especially if the guy's still alive. So, that's that. I mean, there's really, like I was saying there a while back, you know, it has some imperfections and stuff like that. It's really, I mean, for this one, you can see the grain. You can see the grain. There's actually a scarf joint. You can actually see the scarf joint through the thing. If you don't know what a scarf joint is, it's where they match the two pieces of wood together. And it's supposed to make this portion of the neck sturdier. But normally if it falls, that's where it breaks. You know, pretty much right at the scarf joint. It's supposed to make it, I think it's that for that, and because it's easier for them to cut the wood, because it's only 1 inch. This is like a little over, like probably an inch and a half blocks, so they can make the rest of this from another set of freaking blocks, and they don't have to waste so much wood. I don't know. I mean, as you're talking mass production and stuff like that, so. That's that. Fine. Necks are fine and everything like that. I was just reading up a tidbit of information. Because I was looking at Stevie Ray Vaughan's freaking axe. Turns out that the frets that he uses, that he chose to use, weren't even like, you know, the kind of frets that you and I would use for a regular guitar. They were used for bass guitar. Their bass guitar fret wire. So I was like, I'm not even gonna try that. This guy is freaking beyond. I mean, you want to talk about somebody who was beating the freaking guitar pretty bad? He was beating the guitar pretty bad. I mean, if you could look off at the nut on this, it like comes off the wood. The nut actually comes off the wood. There's a little piece for it where actually it sits on there, but half of it is like off the wood. Sounds good. I mean, like I said, you know, it sounds good, clean. Well, for some reason, and I gotta say, the other pickups were like freaking, they're not that great, but they sound really good in my freaking, in my blue freaking one, in the Harmony HD90. And that's fine. This guy, and this is back, this is going back 2008, right? So, but he says here, I have two Stedman Pro Les Paul style guitars. They are light and easy to play in fast action. Once I put on some good strings, because they come with crap strings, so you got to put on some decent slinkies or something like that, you know. The hardware seems RXLs or whatever, you know, whatever your freaking preference is your freaking preference. It's all subjective. You know what I mean? Don't even get me started with that. I had some dipshit freaking comment on my... I'm like, oh my god, I got a comment. One comment, right? He says something about, oh, your line 6 sucks. You better get a Fender. And fucking guy probably doesn't even have a Fender. Doesn't even know what a Fender sounds like. Stupid shit. I'm so glad you wasted your IQ points on a freaking comment. Jackwad. Look, and I'm still looking at the freaking monitor instead of looking at you. I'm sorry. I was going to try to read this, but it's kind of difficult. Because it's really kind of difficult. But the bottom line says, you know, but that's what it was, you know, that's what they do. They go ahead and they sell the damn things for like $300 to $500. He doesn't get it for anything less than, good God, what the hell is this? Anything less than $129. You know what I mean? So you can go out and get yourself a decent friggin' rig for $129. Now, you gotta remember, I mean, this is a beater. You know, it's a freaking good looking beater, and it sounds great, plays great. There ain't nothing wrong with the goddamn thing. But, you know, this is one of those things you could take with to you to your gig or whatever. You don't have to worry about it getting trash. You know, like the guy said on there, you don't have to worry about, you know, trashing your $2,000 freaking Gibson. I mean, to me, that's worth it. I mean, it's a quality piece. It's not like it, I don't think you're going to get freaking much pinch squeals, but you could probably, I mean, you could probably try, you know? I mean, the one thing that I would take this out for, not for metal. That's basically the bottom line. If you want to bring it out there for metal, definitely change the pickups to regular freaking pickups. Go out there and get a regular, you know, a regular set of freaking Duncan, Seymour Duncans or Damasios, you know, and freaking, you know, or bare knuckle or whatever, you know, you're into. And throw them in and slap them in there and then see if you can get it to freaking wail. Because the stock pickups that it comes with, from what I'm hearing, they're not potted. So, you know, you throw it up over 5 and whatever, and she's going to start squealing on you. And not in a nice way. So, you know, that's one thing. I mean, the other thing is, you know, the fretting is fine. You may have to tweak out your action and stuff like that to make sure that it's doing what it's supposed to be doing. And what a little bitch. What the hell is going on that it's freaking eating up so much? Sounds great. So anyway, as I was saying in the other video that I put into that sounded like completely crap. Knockoff. It's a knockoff, and it's the kind of knockoff where they sell them in bulk. They send them to, they're ordered by other freaking manufacturers who slap their name on them, sell them as their own. And that's the story with them. And they wind up in big box retailers, you know, for a premium, right? So they sell them for like $500. You can get them for like $129. For $129 Les Paul, how you freaking go wrong? You need a decent quality, you know, workhorse that's gonna take you out there, and you're going to play the damn thing. Gonna get some decent sustain out of it, you know, and tones where you can carry on a gig and not have to worry about some freaking fool knocking the goddamn thing over or losing it or even getting it stolen. You know what I mean? Fine. The finish is a freaking photo finish. It's gotta be a photo finish. I mean, it's gotta be a photo finish. So, but it's done very well. I mean, they did the glossing and the shellac and whatever they freaking do to it. Very well. I mean, it's buffed out freaking beautifully. I mean, I can't complain. For $100 and some odd, I mean, it's a workhorse. If I need to freaking use it as a go-to, then it'll be the go-to. And all right, so that's that. This is the Stedman Pro. Get one at your local dealer, slap your own freaking sticker on it, and sell it for your own. Sell it as your own. That's the bottom line. You know what I mean? So we'll see. I mean, I ain't gonna complain. Not at all. Someone was saying they wanted one of these things because it had a bolt-on neck, and so it was so it'd be easier to change the neck if it freaking goes to poop later on. Not a bad idea. I mean, for $100, I mean, you can buy a freaking neck for $100 over in Warmoth, you know, and it'll be better, but not by much, really, if you think about it. It's a maple neck. I mean, how much better are you going to get? You can go with another tone wood or whatever. And whatever. I mean, if I could find another one of these things, Stedman Pro, for as a, you know, as a piece of crap beater, but the neck is in freaking great shape, I'll jump on that son of a bitch really quick and replace the freaking neck on my back's on while I completely take that neck apart and take it down to the truss rod. Because there's a twist in it and the truss rod is busted, so I gotta take the truss rod out of there and replace it. I gotta replace it and then put a new fretboard on, and then, you know, do that thing, and then the frets and then the inlays and all of that stuff. And I'm not gonna get too crazy with the inlays. They got some really good stuff on there. If you go and you check, you got the damn they got these decals. They're so fine. They're right up against the grain. You wouldn't even know. And a lot of these things are really, they're decals. I mean, really, they're not really inlays. And you can tell because they're always fucking crooked and shit. So, it, you know, at some point or another. I think I was in a rush when I changed out the pots, because the pickups, because I don't remember looking at the inside of the cavities to check out the wood. And, but I'll do that. I'll just pop off the back again and take a look at it and see what that's like. And then I can tell you what the story is with the body. From what I understand, they're maple necks, rosewood fingerboards. Binding is fine. The fretwork is clean, which means it's not going to cut you up, you know, because it's not, there's no overhang. There's a decent space there. And otherwise, you know, you take this to, it'll play. I mean, it'll work for you. You could take it out to the gigs and whatever and beat this damn thing to death. And and have a good old time with it, you know, and enjoy yourself and not have to worry that, you know, somebody spills their beer on it or somebody knocks it over or whatever. I mean, you know, nobody wants, you know, you never want your axe to go through hell to begin with, but things happen, you know, and you'd rather have it happen to a $100 guitar than to a $2,000 Gibson or whatever. So that's the story with that. And, but otherwise, the frets are decent frets. They're not jumbos. Actually, they're not thins. They're the mediums. So that's that. The action is fine. You know, you got to play with the setup and everything else. Change the goddamn strings. And don't freaking complain about the strings, you jackwads. Because the strings that come with anything from overseas is coming from overseas. Give me a break. You know, how good do you expect? They're not going to be XLs. They're not going to be slinkies. They're not going to be, you know. They're going to be freaking whatever cheap-ass strings they can freaking throw on there to get the thing out the door. And that's it. Bottom line. But it's a fucking good guitar. I love it. You know, it's nice for what it does. And I gotta admit, Well, I won't admit it right yet. I'll come back from the store and then I'll admit to what I wanted to admit to, and then we'll get, you know, we'll take it from there. Because then I'll have a proper manner of comparison. But that's the story with that. So if somebody asks and you've come across it or whatever, and you know, that's the story, Jerry. Why? I mean, if you can enjoy yourself out there, and definitely, if you're practicing, if you're in, you know, if you're a newbie, if you're a beginner, plop down, get the $100 and freaking get yourself a decent guitar. This is a decent guitar. For the money, and you ain't got to worry about Jack, freaking yeah, man. Freaking yeah. Do it, man. Always go used if you have the opportunity. I mean, it's fun. First of all, it's fun. I mean, unless you have the ducats to plop down a couple of grand, you know, for your first guitar, which is doesn't really make sense to me, but outside of, you know, I mean, if you get like a PRS or something like that where it's perfect, like right out of the box, little to nothing to do to get it set up and running for you, then I would say definitely go ahead and do it, you know, because you're not. And even then, you know, you're going to go through whatever you're going to go through because you're just learning everything. Your finger's going to kill you no matter what. But I think when you're first starting out, with the one thing you want to do is you don't want your fingers killing you. So you want your action and your setup to be as comfortable as possible. So, because your finger's going to hurt anyway, period. I don't care who the hell you are. You know what I mean? If you're a construction worker and you want to pick up the guitar for the first time, I mean, your hands may be rough, but those fingertips of yours, they ain't as rough as you think they are. Hold some chords for about freaking 2 hours, and you tell me how tough you are. I'm no joke. Guitar players know what I'm talking about. So anyway, that's the deal with that. You know, get yourself something you can freaking bang for a while, and not have to worry about it. This is Dan Lopez, and I'm just chilling the frick out with the guitars in the frickin' bedroom. There's a title there somewhere. I'm working on it. I promise you, somewhere. So, that's the story with that. Love you. See if I can come up with a story for something else. Oh, yeah. I got to come up with a story for the harmony to find out what the hell the story is with the harmony guitars. And then, I got a few others. All right. Peace. I'll talk to you lads later after my freaking computer stopped overheating. Dumb thing.